We must defeat Lu Bu here and stop the chaos. Although we cannot avoid hurting some innocent citizens, I decided to go ahead with our plan to devastate the city by flooding it. The stalemate here has given demons the opportunity to invade the city. This means Lu Bu may have no choice but to turn to his prized elixir. Well, we'll be relying on your abilities.
Ugh! Everything's completely destroyed. The water has slowed down now, but we'll still need to find a path that's not waterlogged. The whole town's totally flooded. I wonder if it's this bad where my brother is.
Blessed! The entire city has been flooded. Are there no lengths that Ker Chow Chow will not stoop to?
The flow isn't as strong as before, but it will be cold given the season. Falling in could be fatal, so watch your feet. Here. Could you help me out? My brother and I grew up in was caught in the crossfire of a war, too. The house was destroyed, our parents killed, and I could do nothing except cry. But he kept pushing me to keep hope. We supported each other and just about managed to stay alive. Then my master found us and took us to Mount Kandrushan.
Yeah. Thank you.
dear. They're tougher than I thought they'd be. Was it? rest up a little? Was this? Are you all right? Just how weak had that floor gotten to fall through completely? His habit, when something troubled him, was to turn his back. He's no different now from when he was a child. So, I don't understand why. What led him down this path? I can't deny what he's done. Killing his master, taking the elixir, stirring up conflict. But that's not the Lubu I knew. I need to find out what happened, what changed him. My brother was extremely serious about his training in martial arts and wizardry spells. And all because he wanted to protect me. You are my responsibility, Hongjin, is what he'd always say. And it was true. He always looked after me. This time, though, it's I that must become the protector. It's unavoidable that Cao Cao's forces will try to kill him. But if I can get him to stand down, then... will you lend me your aid? I have no one else to rely on. Here until just recently. And now, just empty houses, roads. The flooding tactics really were devastating.
Yeah!
be a challenge. Don't get careless.
Thank you.
area's heavily guarded. That probably means my brother is close.
Yeah!
That could make a big difference.
Stand against impossible hardship. So then why? Why not use the elixir?
I was waiting for this moment! The blight of the elixir. It all ends here, and now.
Side. Be useful and destroy each other.
Help me out.
I'll need to be careful on this mission.
Yeah!
I knew immediately that I had to destroy Yuji after finding out this chaos was his doing. A Taoist spreading a vile elixir and controlling demons has no right to tread this land. I cannot allow the people of my village, who made me who I am, or my one and only flesh and blood, to get caught up in this madness. That is why I left my village and pledged a false allegiance to Dong Zhuo to infiltrate their forces. I hope to track Yuji's actions. I swallowed my pride and did their bidding. I brought the elixir to Meiwu Fort and was able to prevent it from spreading among the lords. Yet, I was still unable to pin down Yuji. So, in my desperation, I risked everything. I stole the elixir. I figured if I sat on it without using it myself, he would eventually show his face. And it worked. But I came one step short. You bested me. Perhaps you can take Yuji down. The responsibility of bringing an end to the spread of demonic chi is in your hands now.
You get involved. He fought a long, hard, and lonely fight.
Seems not only Shu Province, but many of our other cities have fallen to Yuan Shao as well.
And I don't know where my brothers are.
General Guan.
Hmm?
If you have no objections, how about staying with Minister Cao for the time being? It will not be easy for you to search for General Liu until these enemy forces are defeated.
Hmm.
I could see General Yuan's star falling. And three new stars have risen up. What might this portend?
Yuan Shao suddenly heads south toward Cao Cao's territory and steals the elixir that Lu Bu had been safeguarding. Yuan Shao now commanded an army of demons, striking fear into the hearts of many and allowing him to secure footholds across the land.
With tiredness and fear spreading among his men, Cao Cao faced crushing odds, but his star burned yet brightly. He roused his loyal army and went out on an all-or-nothing attack.
Xiao's forces have taken the Yanjin Fort.
Our vanguard heading for Baima has been taken out by the enemy generals Yan Liang and Wen Chou.
You have treated me with such kindness. Allow me to return the favor, Minister Cao. I shall bring you the enemy commander's head.
How many men will you need?
I will need just one.
Yuan Shao's forces are strong. Be careful. So, m'lady, what did the stars tell you now?
We shall only know when this battle is through, my lord.
There's one primary strategic point on the river crossing here in Baima. The one who takes it can prevent enemy reinforcements.
Exactly. Cao Cao will do everything in his power to cover his losses. However, our goals are different. We must find the Taoists who killed our father.
Cao Cao's army has reached Baima.
I want Xiao Aman's head now.
Yes, my lord. We will do whatever it takes.
Do you hear me? Let none say we lack forces anymore!
Without my sworn brothers by my side now, it is but you I can entrust my life with. Let us depart.
The fear in General Yuan's heart led him to become consumed by darkness. The retainers that once served him have left. Now all that lingers at his side are those twisted demons and conjurers. The stars remain uncertain of how the future will unfold. But I believe you have the power to guide us down the right path. The fear in General Yuan's the stars.
If we lay down our swords here, there will be no one else who can put a stop to Yuan Shao. We ask much of our allies. For this is not a task we can accomplish unscathed.